Yeah, you say during that period, as a result of your new freedom and having faced persecution, that now you ended up maybe being a little overzealous and to the point where you made some mistakes that you now regret. Can you go into that a little? What are some of the mistakes that you made at that early period?
Yes, I was preparing a lot of debates with Muslims on the Quran, on the Hadith, or the life of their prophet. And I was trying to win debates, and Muslims would invite their friends, and I would invite my friends, and we would go at each other, and I've never seen a single conversion through that. I was getting really angry, they were getting really angry, and they were trying to win, and at the end, they thought they won, and I thought I won. So that was a mistake. I mean, there is a place for debates. But when you're trying to win people to Christ, we really need to preach the gospel as it is. And knowing that there is no gospel in Islam, that's what they need. Not a debater who is trying to win an argument with a stick.
Yeah, where there's more heat than light.
Yes, yes.
You know, Fikret, here in the West, we hear a lot of conflicting things about the meaning of jihad. As a former Muslim, what's your understanding of the meaning of that word?
Well, jihad is like it's a struggle. It means struggle or fight against the enemies of Islam. It's not an attempt to convert people to Islam by force. Rather, it's an attempt to expand and extend Islam until the whole world is under Islamic rule. So that is jihad. If you look at it this way, jihad is Islamic missions.
Gotcha.
Jihad is essentially a permanent state of either there's the friendly jihad or not so friendly jihad. It's essentially a permanent, it can be a permanent state of hostility that Islam maintains against the rest of the world, against the rest of non-Muslims, with or without fighting for more sovereignty over more territory. So it's a duty, it's an obligation for every Muslim who call themselves devout Muslims. You know, it's a contrast between Christ with Muhammad. Christ said, he who lives by the sword will die by the sword. But Muhammad said, the sword is the key to heaven and hell.
Hmm.